Hi, whether you are a designer looking for ways to automate your image processing tasks, or a photographer looking to enhance and watermark your photos, or just someone trying to resize or convert large batch of images, you have picked the right tool for the job. This short video will help you get started by giving you easy, step-by-step instructions that illustrate typical workflow and highlight core features designed to save you loads of time and effort. So let's get started. Image processing workflow consists of three basic steps. First, choose processing mode and images for processing. Then, specify actions to perform on those images. And finally, choose where and how to save processed images and begin processing. Main window represents each step by a distinct region where all the step details can be configured. On the left, you choose processing mode and specify images that need to be processed. On the right, you specify processing tasks with ability to choose from more than 100 actions, filters, effects, and conditions. Finally, at the bottom, you choose where and how processed images should be saved and begin the processing. Images can be processed in any one of the four available modes. Main processing mode, where you manually initiate the processing after explicitly specifying images to be processed. Automatic or background processing mode, where program continually monitors folders for changes and automatically processes matching images according to the rules you specify. Scheduled or triggered processing mode, that is automatically initiated based on specified time or trigger. Command line mode, that is similar to manual mode but operates in a console window or without any user interface. In the rest of this video, we'll cover main processing mode. To begin, you must specify what images the program should work with. There are quite a few ways to do it. The most basic is to add image files individually. You can also add all images from a given folder. You can also recursively scan specified folder for all images matching various properties you can specify, like file name, file attributes, image properties like size, and many others. All matching images will be automatically added for processing. You can also copy-paste files from clipboard. Simply select the desired files in your favorite file manager, copy them to clipboard, return to the program, and paste them. All the files you just copied will be added. Images can also be added by copy-pasting a list of file paths that may contain paths with wildcards and point to both files and folders. Last but not least, you can drag and drop image files directly from Windows Explorer, which is especially handy if you have a multi-monitor setup. Once you have specified the images you want to process, you need to tell the program what operations should be performed on those images. To do this, simply drag and drop desired actions and effects. Each action usually comes with various settings that you can customize in the area below the actions list. Some actions have quite a few settings that are grouped into tabs. Any changes you make to the action settings are reflected in the actions list next to the selected action. There are over 100 actions and effects to choose from, and you can add as many of them as is necessary to accomplish your goal. Actions can also be added by double-clicking on the desired item in the Actions bar. Actions list reflects the processing order, which can be easily changed using mouse drag and drop or with keyboard keys. You can easily preview the effects of various actions on the resulting images by clicking on the image thumbnail. The preview area shows both the original and the modified version of an image side by side. As you zoom and pan one view, the other automatically stays in sync, making it easy to spot the differences. The preview window shows a lot of information, but if you just need to see the modified image, you can toggle off other panels to maximize the viewing area. As you adjust various action settings, the preview automatically reflects the results, so you know ahead of time what the processed image will look like. You can add branching to processing flow using conditions. A condition can be added by drag and dropping it to the desired position in the actions list. Conditions check a given image against a predefined set of characteristics. If all the requirements set by a condition are satisfied, processing will continue. Otherwise, all actions nested inside a condition will be skipped. Here, we're nesting contrast and brightness actions within the image size condition, so that these actions will be performed only on images whose width is bigger than 1000 pixels as the condition requires. You can easily find the desired action simply by searching for it in the actions bar. When no longer needed, the actions bar can be collapsed with a click of a button. If your action sequence contains more than a handful of items, it may be a good idea to save it as a template for future use. You will then be able to easily restore all the actions and settings from a saved template file, saving yourself a lot of time. Once you have selected images and specified actions to perform, you need to specify output settings like file names, save location, and image format. To give processed images desired file names, you can either choose from a list of predefined templates or create your own template using a dedicated window with a variety of built-in tags that let you use various file and image attributes, including exit data, as part of a new file name. Save location can be specified as either absolute or relative folder path or chosen from a predefined drop-down list. You can save processed images in more than 15 different formats that you can choose from a drop-down list. You can further customize format-specific options in a preview dialog that shows what the saved image will look like given selected quality and image format settings. Once all the desired output settings have been specified, you can begin processing by clicking on the Start button. Processing progress will be visually displayed on the image list and in the status area below. When processing is finished, program will display a brief summary message. Processed image thumbnails are color-coded and show changed properties in bold, so you can easily see if the processing succeeded and images were saved with proper file names and in correct location. This concludes our short tour. We hope we got you interested and you'll give it a try. Thank you for watching.